everyone. Welcome to online service of Hillsong Church. And we're happy to have you if you've joined us for the first time. Please stay to the end. We believe this service will be a blessing to you. In the beginning, we're going to pray together. I believe it's an honor and privilege. Even when we're online, as a church, we're in unity and we can pray together. And I know that life sometimes is hard. And we can see this in the prayers that you see on your screens. But also, I know that when regular people with faith inside are joined together to pray, prayer works, God answers our prayers. So let's pray together about the church, about the needs of people, and for God's will to be in our life. So let's pray in the beginning of the service. Dear Lord, thank you for your mercy and goodness. Thank you for your grace that you give for every season of our life. Thank you for your mercy is renewed every day. Thank you for all the blessings that we had past 2-3 months. We believe that you prepared something new for the next 3 months in the name of Jesus Christ. And I pray that your perfect will be on earth as in heaven. Your will be in every person's life through the prayer. I proclaim healing in the name of Jesus. I proclaim salvation in the name of Jesus. I proclaim answers miraculously in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Also want to say that we're thankful to everyone who keeps giving, because church stays strong during this season, and we were able to take care of people who were in need. And let's just keep being generous. We heard a lot of testimonies that God did in this hard season, and we believe that He will and He can do even more than we can imagine. The Bible says that the one who takes care of others will be taken care of God by God. And we believe in this. And let's prepare our hearts to worship God, and our team will help us with this.
Слов пустых не нужно, пусть звучит тебе хвала. Не стремлюсь я в песне окунуться в чувства. Тебя, ведь ты сила я царя. Let's go. тобою, Божий покой. Я погружаюсь в глубины Его. В объятиях любви скрой меня, Бог. Бьется рекою Божий покой. О величии Твоем пою я перед Тобой склонюсь. Ты все для меня, Иисус. Я для Тебя живу. Я для Тебя живу. Дух, изливайся, дождем на меня. Яви то, что скрыто, открой небеса. Меня наполняешь, когда славлю Тебя. Дух, изливайся. О величии Твоем пою я перед Тобой склонюсь. Ты все для меня, Иисус. Я для Тебя живу. О величии Твоем пою я перед Тобой. Пусть распахнутся двери небес, милость сердца наполни. Духом сойди к нам и силу излей, когда поем святой Бог. Пусть распахнутся сердца наполни. Духом сойди к нам и силу излей, когда поем святой Бог. Пусть распахнутся двери небес, милость сердца наполни. Духом сойди к нам и силу излей, когда
дай нас здесь и сейчас. Действуй, Святой Дух, открой небеса. В силе зайди, Бог, взывает земля. Ты творил чудеса, сотвори их опять. О, пробуждай нас здесь и сейчас. Действуй, Святой Дух, открой небеса. В силе зайди, Бог, сотвори их опять. Бог, пробуждай нас здесь и сейчас. Действуй, Святой Дух, открой небеса. В силе сойди, Бог, взывает земля. Святой Дух, открой небеса, силе сойди, Бог, запоет земля. Ты творил чудеса, сотвори их опять. Безгранично доверяюсь Духу Бога, пусть ведет меня по водам туда, куда призвал Он. И в глубинах те, что не преодолеть мне, станет вера моя крепче, когда рядом мой Спаситель. Безгранично доверяюсь Духу Бога, пусть ведет меня по водам туда, куда призвал Он. И в глубинах те, что не преодолеть мне, станет вера моя крепче, когда рядом мой Спаситель. На тебя смещу, ты дашь покой во время бурь, ведь я в тебе, а ты во мне.
I love worship.
Оно не только нравится
моей душе,
но это помогает моему духу держать свой фокус, взор на Христе, помогает мне помнить, кем является Бог, и помогает мне доверять Богу в любовь в ее жизни. Мне также нравится песня поклонения, которую мы пели сегодня,
океан.
Там такие строки: безгранично доверяюсь Духу Бога, пусть ведет меня по водам туда, куда призвал Он.
Trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever it would call me. Take me deeper than my feet could ever wander. And my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior. We usually ask each other, how are you? How's your life? But I want to ask you, how's your faith today?
Стала ли она крепче за последние 2-3 месяца, или она ослабела?
Or it became weak.
Следующие 30 минут я хотел бы говорить о
вере speak about faith
и о том, как вера крепнет и закаляется,
made stronger,
проходя различные
going through different seasons of life. And it is good, even when we face challenges, because in these challenges, our faith becomes stronger. Let's take our Bibles and pray. Dear Lord,
we ask you to speak to us.
Make our faith stronger, spirit make stronger, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Jesus told to his disciples that it does not matter how big or small your faith is,
даже маленькая Even вера может делать большие чудеса в этом мире. Веришь ли ты в это
today?
Сегодня? Но мне особенно нравится, как о вере like говорит апостол James Иаков в своем послании. Он говорит о том, что вера должна быть живой. И когда вера жива, она подкрепляется какими-то делами. С другой стороны, когда вера не движет нас никаким делами, не подкрепляется делами,
deeds,
он говорит, что такая вера мертва и ничего не может сделать или изменить в этом мире. То есть неважно, насколько моя вера была большой 5-10 лет назад, важно, насколько она живая сегодня, насколько она меня побуждает каким-то делам или шагам веры сегодня. В прошлом году в Лондоне я был в музее естествознания. Это было просто потрясающе. Потому что там в полный рост ты видишь по тем раскопкам и костям, которые находят ученые, реальный размер динозавров и мамонтов в прошлом. И ты знаешь, неважно, насколько большими монстрами они были в прошлом, сегодня
today,
они никого не напугают,
scare anyone,
потому что они мертвы. Неважно, насколько большой моя вера была вчера, важно, насколько жива она сегодня. Верю ли я, доверяю ли я Богу сегодня, делаю ли я сегодня свои шаги по вере? Я не хочу, чтобы моя вера казалась большой или была большой, но бездейственной. Другими словами, неважно, насколько влиятельной, действенной она была вчера, важно, насколько она живая, крепкая, сильная, сегодня. Я хочу задать
today.
Вопрос сегодня
I want
каждому,
to ask everyone today,
как твоя вера сегодня? Мне нравится, насколько практично написано о вере в послании Иакова. И давайте
James
вместе откроем, мы сегодня будем читать именно из послания Иакова 1 главы.
Now, James,
я буду читать из нового русского перевода NIV.
I will read from NIV.
Вы также можете следить в синодальном переводе или в том, который открыт у вас в ваших Библиях. Я буду читать со 2 по 4 стих.
Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Let perseverance finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything.
Apostle James says about several stages of maturity of faith in the life of every person.
He's not just speaking about faith being big,
как будто
like
она была маленькой и должна стать больше. Нет. Но, или, знаете, другими словами, как будто заметной для других, видимой для других людей. Нет, не это важно.
It's
важно, чтобы вера, в конце концов, стала
mature.
Зрелой.
Have
Думал
you ever thought about this?
Об этом? Чтобы наша вера
faith,
от начала и потом какому-то проходящему из разных периодов жизни life, стала более зрелой. И все послание Иакова на самом деле раскрывает эту мысль, как вера взрослеет и становится крепче в нашей жизни. И из этого отрывка, который мы прочитали с 2 по 4 стих, мы можем выделить три этапа взросления веры. Это испытанная вера, стойкая вера и зрелая вера. И я хотел бы немного сегодня поговорить о каждом из этих этапов, и как это происходит в нашей жизни, и в конце сделать важный вывод. Поэтому,
stages.
Если вы останетесь и дослушаете до конца,
end,
вы услышите,
you will be
потому
able
что
to
все это ведет к этому выводу. Несколько этапов роста и взросления веры. Итак, первое.
So,
испытанная вера. Яков говорит
James
во втором стихе. Я прочитаю еще раз.
Joy,
когда вы сталкиваетесь с различного рода испытаниями, считайте это великой радостью. Я, честно, не встречал тех людей, которые
me,
просто вот
family,
очень радуются, когда приходят в жизни какие-то проблемы, включая меня, мою семью, мою жену,
usually we say,
когда
oh,
приходят
no,
какие-то испытания, трудности
But
или
James
проблемы,
says,
мы чаще всего на
trials and challenges
снова.
Can produce something good in our life.
Говорит о том, что Especially испытания или какие-то трудности, они
It's
могут делать что-то хорошее в нашей жизни
between
и особенно в контексте веры. Важно понимать каждому человеку разницу между испытаниями
in verse
и искушениями.
In Synodal translation,
в синодальном переводе, в этом же месте, во втором стихе,
говорится
и написано слово «искушение».
But original Greek word,
а мы прочитали НЛП «испытание». Но
has two meanings.
Оригинальное
First,
греческое слово,
temptation,
которое использовано здесь,
and second trials.
Оно имеет на самом деле
and
два
I believe
значения.
It speaks about trials,
Первое,
but it's important to understand the difference between
Но я верю, что здесь действительно говорится об испытаниях. Но нам важно
temptation
понимать разницу между искушениями и испытаниями.
God.
Искушение – это то, что нацелено увести тебя от Бога,
to break some principles
увести
that you build your life
от веры.
Upon.
Чтобы ты нарушил какие-то принципы, на которых ты строишь свою жизнь. Возможно, ты принял решение строить свою жизнь на каких-то основаниях, на каких-то принципах, но под давлением обстоятельств из-за какой-то экономии или какой-то кажущейся выгоды, быстрой выгоды, мы идем на какие-то компромиссы. И вот эти компромиссы, это и есть искушения, которые уводят нас
What examples in the Bible you can see?
Жизни,
temptation in the
Какие примеры в Библии
Garden of Eden?
Искушение
the tree
в Эдемском саду. Было дерево добро, познание добра и зла.
You know, it
Было
never tempted anyone, but it was forbidden until
Но, знаешь,
the serpent
искушало,
began to speak with Eve.
Было запрет,
and this
до
things
того момента,
that he
told
her
became temptation
for her.
Те вещи, которые он говорил
Or
Еве,
temptation of Jesus in the desert.
Например, искушение Иисуса
We know that before his public ministry, Jesus spent 40 days in the desert. The desert itself was not the temptation. It was a trial. But the temptation was the conversation with the devil when the devil became to tempt Jesus with his words and questions.
In the
13th verse of James, he says, When tempted, no one should say, God is tempting me, for God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt anyone. It's important that God never tempts anyone. But God sometimes lets trials in our life. Why? Because trials are aimed for you to become better, for you to become stronger,
for your faith
to become stronger, and for you to be
чтобы твоя вера стала крепче,
cleaner before God as gold. That is why Greek word that is used by James in the
Поэтому
second verse
греческое слово,
is not about
temptation Иаковом
that leads to sin, but to trial that leads to something bigger, better, that cleanses our life. And I want to repeat, temptation is not making us faith stronger. It leads us away. But trials tempers our faith. In other words, we need trials in our life.
И другими словами, они даже нужны нам в жизни.
The word is used by James, this Greek word,
которое использует Иаков, Это древнегреческое слово. Греки говорили, что птенец испытывает свои крылья, когда он только начинает
летать.
Перевод Ветхого Завета на древнегреческий язык, там также использовано вот это слово «испытание».
Queen of Sheba
О царице Савской в Третьем царстве, 10 главе, 1 стихе, говорится, что она пришла, чтобы испытать, использовано это же слово, мудрость Соломона своими загадками. В Библии также сказано, что Бог
And
сам
God
Бог испытывал,
Abraham,
использовано это же слово, Авраама, когда
him to sacrifice
он явился ему,
only son as a burnt offering.
Принял жертву своего единственного сына, Исаака, своего любимого единственного сына.
In Genesis 22. When Israelites
Исаака.
Came to
Это
the
об
promised
этом говорится
land,
в Матфея 22 главе. Когда израильский
God didn't
народ пришел
out,
в обетованную землю, Бог не убрал
them,
и не выгнал другие народы, которые жили вокруг Него, но они как бы испытывали Его народ,
tested,
и через эти жизненные обстоятельства
Israel
израильский народ
Everyone
он
of us live in the world
становился сильнее.
Where
каждый
we feel
из нас
pressure, by trials and challenges, and we need to remember that we need them to become better for our faith to become stronger.
Trials, challenges, and crises or
problems
is not what 99% of people love, 100%
of people love,
but
what it makes us better,
makes us
faith stronger. What can we learn from this? That God sometimes let trials in your life
to make you better, to
make your faith stronger. That's why it is important to go through and deal with challenges and trials and not run away from them.
Because
when we run from problems, that we need to handle ourselves, meet them face to face.
We're
like running away from God's plan in our life. Because God's plan for us is to go through this, to be victorious, to fight these giants, to have our faith stronger. And we remember that God's will is good, pleasing, and perfect. Apostle Paul says about this. It's not to destroy our life, but to make you better and your life better. That is why indecisiveness sometimes doesn't let God do some good things in our life.
Because
sometimes we put our problems on the long finger to deal with this later. But through these situations, God wants to teach us something, make us stronger, and prepare us for something bigger in front of us. Just think about this. When we put our problems on the long finger, we think that we will deal with them later, and the problem doesn't disappear. We will have to deal with it, but we will have to pay a different price through every life situation. We take out some lessons. God prepares for something bigger and better. That is why sometimes people need to face problems in the area of finances to deal with them and become better in something, be faithful in small things to deal with this, so God will trust us more, like to keep your word. I have noticed that people who doesn't keep their word in small things, they will not keep their word in big things. People who
don't
finish something in small things, they don't finish something in big. Some things that needed my faith and total trust to God. Situations when you think, God, why am I going through this? Why me?
You
know, it didn't destroy my life, but made me stronger, made me better. Some circumstances that I had in my childhood, in sports, in leadership, in family life, no matter all this, it made me stronger, even when I faced challenges, and we all have hardships in our life. Just don't look and trust Instagram of other people. All you see in his Instagram is not everything. People have challenges, trials that they go through.
And often,
people will never see this
in social networks.
But this is between them and God.
Но это между ними Богом, и это укрепляет его веру,
God,
и это поднимает его выше.
Faith comes from hearing God's word.
Вера от слышания.
And it's true, but our faith needs trials and tested.
Но
faith is not theory.
Также нужны испытания. It becomes our life. Испытанная вера. Это не просто
теория.
Она становится частью нашей жизни, когда мы реально доверяем Богу.
This kind of faith is active. It can protect us. From trials and even from temptations that we all have. That is why in this song, Oceans, we sing, Spirit, lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk up on the waters wherever you would call me. When God leads us where He has called us, on the way, you will have trials, you will have challenges. We need not to run away from them. We don't need to be afraid. Maybe it's for something bigger to prepare us for that. Maybe you think that everything looks like you need to walk on the water again, trust the Lord 100% again. But if God called you, you need to say, I can do this in the name of Jesus Christ. I can make all things in Jesus Christ. If God called you to be where you are, no matter what, trust God, and your faith will be made stronger. When our faith is tested, when we go through life's challenges, even crisis, when we had for the past 3 months, that makes us better, it makes us, our faith tempered. And the next stage is persistent faith. So James says, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Another synonym is patience, self-control, persistence, and endurance.
Стойка.
The wind cannot blow when it goes away. You will still be standing on what you believe on. You keep standing on God's principles in any season of your life. This is enduring faith, persistent faith. We believe that for the miracle, you just need faith. Jesus made a lot of miracles by faith. God can do this. God loves them. But God calls us not only to believe when we need a miracle, but also He calls us to live out by faith every day. In other words, to believe every day. Have this persistent faith. Not only faith, not just unpack it when we need it, and hide it back when we don't need it. No, God calls us to live by faith every day. This is the persistent faith. This kind of faith will transform our life, will bring good fruit in our life, and we will see how our life is transformed. Faith that is ready to wait, faith that is ready to stand in the gap. If I don't see the answers to my prayer, I will keep praying. I will ask my brothers and sisters to pray. I will speak about this in church. We'll pray together, but I will expect when God will answer my prayer. This is the persistent faith. And this kind of faith, Jesus called His disciples to. Faith that is ready not to give up. When Abraham was waiting for Isaac for 25 years, Caleb, when he was 80, he said, I'm like 40 years old, I can conquer the promised land. Job had this kind of faith. Disciples of Jesus had that kind of faith. Before Jesus trusted the big mission in our life, he taught them to have this kind of faith. Faith that is ready to wait for fruit, not just to wait, but to do something, to make, do next steps in faith, to grow in what we do as a church right now. In this song, we're also saying, take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger. And my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
Станет вера моя крепче.
In this deep, when I cannot go through by my own, my faith will be stronger because my Savior is next to me. Amen? That is why tested faith becomes persistent.
Поэтому испытанная вера становится стойкой со временем. Там на глубине есть испытания, которые
that are not from God, or that God wants to have us to have them, like
Бог
our
хочет,
health,
чтобы были в нашей жизни.
When we're sick.
И это такие вещи, например,
when
как наше здоровье, или когда,
I don't believe
когда мы болеем,
when our children are sick,
когда наши дети болеют.
That is
я не
because
верю, что когда наши дети болеют,
sin.
Это из-за того, что их родители согрешили.
We live
нет,
in
это,
the world.
Это из-за того, что мы живем в мире.
When we had
ты знаешь,
Emma,
когда у нас с Аней появилась первая дочь,
first
Emma,
year of her life, she
первый
was
год жизни,
sick
она много
really
болела.
Often. couldn't help her, we saw a lot of doctors. And I can say that during this season of her life, the first year of her life, our faith became so strong.
Наша вера стала настолько
крепкой, сильной, стойкой, чем когда-либо раньше.
И мы увидели свое чудо Божье во имя Иисуса Христа. Поэтому испытанная вера, она ведет нас к чему-то большему. Стойкая вера ведет к большей жизни. Life
because of your strong faith.
Когда вся твоя жизнь становится больше, из-за того, что твоя вера крепка. Но когда вера становится закаленной, постоянной, выносливой, снова и снова, снова и снова продолжает становиться крепче,
not because God wants something bad for you,
даже в каких-то
because we live in a sinful world,
не потому что Бог хочет чего-то плохого для тебя, но потому что мы живем в грешном мире,
and He's ready to lead us through any season of life, any challenges and bad things in life. And in time, this kind of faith becomes mature faith. Let's read verse 4. Let perseverance finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. I like that James says here that this mature faith lets us be complete.
Complete Christians without any lack.
It's important.
Недостатков. Это важно, то, что здесь говорится, потому что мы становимся лучше не благодаря религиозным правилам, которые мы исполняем, каким-то законам, которые мы исполняем, но нашей вере.
Wrong things are absent in your life. When faith in Jesus Christ is tested through the pressure that we have in this world, it becomes strong. And in time it becomes mature and we become the way that God sees us. We become more and more like Christ. What I mean when I say mature faith? Mature faith is ready to understand that God wants us to be a blessing to others, not only to bless you. This changes everything. Mature faith is when you understand that life with God is not only to ask God to answer our prayers, but when we understand that my life is for good of other people,
to worship God, to serve others.
This is the mature faith. Mature faith is when you look with the eyes of faith on other people, sinful people, and you see that everyone has his own way with God, journey of God, with God. And when you look at people with eyes of faith, you believe in the potential that God put in every person. This is the mature faith. And I want my faith to be mature. Because only mature fruit brings other fruits.
Only mature fruit brings more fruit.
That is why I want my faith to be mature. When my faith is mature, it brings fruit into my children's life. It can inspire other people to trust life to Christ. But I need to have mature life, a faith. Tested faith leads to something more.
Persistent
faith leads to bigger life, and mature faith has got to act through my life and be blessing to other people. When we moved to Moscow, we were family of believers, Christians, whose faith was tested in previous seasons of life. But I can say that first 3-4 years of faith was like tempered more and more and became more persistent. And I remember at some point we felt like we stopped worrying from circumstances around us, problems and crises that comes into our life, because we thought if God did this before, He will do it again. We stopped worrying and be scared of problems and start to treat them as a normal part of life of every Christian person.
Challenges,
hardships that we face. And I can say that in Moscow our faith began to mature even more before we came here. The more we give our life
Чем больше
to other people,
мы отдаем свою
others,
жизнь ради жизни that и пользы
us. That's not something we regret of.
Это не то, что ограничивает нас. Это не что-то, за что мы жалеем. Это честь и привилегия жить ради пользы
like
других людей. Но это зрелая
so,
вера. Это честь и привилегия служить таким образом Богу.
Tested faith,
чему я
persistent
все это
faith, mature
вел?
Faith.
В конце концов,
in the message of
пытанная
James,
вера, стойкая вера, зрелая вера. Послание Иакова было
not written
написано
by any of,
не одним из
12 of Jesus,
учеников
but James
Иисуса.
Was
она была написана
the blood brother of Jesus Christ,
который
the son of Mary,
кровным братом Иисуса Христа.
And мы read about James
Марии,
and brothers of
sisters,
Jesus the following.
Мы читаем
in the John 7, verse 5, for even his own brothers did not believe in him.
7 главе, 5 стихе. Ибо и братья его не верили
James
в
него. Life,
who
wrote the message of James that teaches us how to have a strong faith, how it goes through different stages of your life. There was a time when James didn't believe that Jesus is God's son, when he didn't believe in Christ. But at some point later, he believed, and we don't find anywhere in the Bible how it happened. We don't know. But there was a moment in the life of James when he believed in Christ. And we see that after this, his faith was tested. He writes about this in his message. And it became strong and mature.
Она стала
because
стойкой, и она стала зрелой.
We see this because
как
James became the leader of Jerusalem church, and apostles were opening churches in other places, but James, brother of Jesus, became the pastor of Jerusalem's church. Wow. And I want to encourage you. Maybe you're going through a season of life when it's hard to trust God. It's not like you don't believe in God, but it's hard to trust Jesus. I would encourage you to keep looking at the grace of Jesus.
Я хочу ободрить тебя. Продолжай смотреть на благодать Иисуса. Продолжай общаться с людьми, которые наполнены верой и которые в своей жизни
keep listening to messages, sermons that are filled with faith, and I believe that you will have a moment in your life, the next step, that you will trust God, the next step of faith, when Jesus will transform everything in your life.
I met
in church people that didn't believe in Jesus.
You may think,
can that happen? Yes. Because people come to church, they're different. Sometimes it's hard for them to trust their life to Christ. They want to know Him personally, but they don't believe in Him. But time passed, every person had this moment of meeting with God, and these kind of people who for some time didn't believe in Jesus, but kept
и такие люди, которые какое-то время не верили в Иисуса, но продолжали ходить на собрания церкви,
to God. Maybe you're going through trials. Maybe you're in a season when your faith is tempered through some pressure or long waiting of God's answers. But I believe that this will lead us to maturity in Christ and it helps.
Но я верю, что это ведет нас к зрелости во Христе, и это помогает какие-то все обстоятельства, которые вокруг, они помогают нам быть теми,
because James was the son of Mary. And many people looking at the life of Mary who gave birth to Jesus see the biggest mission of her life is to give birth to Christ. But she needed faith when angel came, she believed that this will happen, that she will get pregnant from the Holy Spirit.
And
will give birth to God's Son,
сына,
the Savior of the world.
Сын,
and she needed faith to bring up
этого,
God's Son.
Вера, сына.
But after, when Jesus went through His mission on earth, she had another children. She was part of 120 people who were waiting for the Holy Spirit to come down on the Pentecost and were filled with the Holy Spirit. And she had children that she needed to invest
У нее было, были остались дети, в которых ей также нужно было вкладывать веру, возможно, верить и поддерживать их.
It's encouraging to me that James, one of her sons,
ободряет меня, что Иаков,
became the leaders of the church, wrote amazing message,
стал одним из лидеров церкви, написал
потрясающее
послание, которое вошло в Новый Завет и стало частью Библии.
Иаков,
ее второй сын,
who didn't believe in Christ and then believed in some moment. He went through his stages of faith, when his faith was tested, became persistent and then mature. And you know, for every person, in every season of life, there are moments when we need to trust God
again and again, ask God, what plans do you have for me, God,
in this season of life? Because Mary could just stop,
give birth to Jesus, and go on with her life.
But she kept following him. When Jesus died and was resurrected, Mary saw him. When he was resurrected, after this, she needed to keep following Christ.
После этого ей нужно было продолжать church, следовать за Христом,
son,
продолжать быть
James,
частью церкви, возможно, поддерживать своего сына Иакова
Maybe
в том, что он делает
God
для Бога.
In your life. It's not
возможно, раньше
what he
Бог
did
делал
before,
что-то
but in this
жизни.
Of life,
Но послушай, неважно, что он делал раньше, я верю,
great
что в этот период жизни
you.
Бог хочет также делать какие-то That is why очень we need важные to believe
today.
Вещи.
And we need our faith to be
Поэтому
alive today. That's what I was leading to with this message. The life of faith
is
not some event. It's a journey. Wherever you are, wherever your faith is right now,
there's next step of faith for all of us.
Let's pray together. Dear Lord, thank you for mercy and goodness.
Дорогой Господь, спасибо
and
тебе за
many circumstances that strengthen our faith and builds up our spirit
жизни,
through
нашу веру, строит наш
this
дух,
we become
и через которое мы становимся чище, мы
pure and clean
лучше,
and
потому
that
что
you're next to us. I pray
Спаситель,
for people that go through challenges and trials right now.
Людях,
I pray that through this their faith will become stronger. I pray for people who keep praying
Она стала крепче.
Didn't receive their answer,
Я молюсь о тех людях, которые продолжают молиться и, возможно, еще не увидели свой ответ, чтобы они
promises,
продолжали просить, чтобы они продолжали стоять на Божьих обещаниях
Lord,
в своей жизни, чтобы они не отступали в молитве.
Pressure,
Я молюсь, Господь,
and I pray that this person
о каждом
would be
человеке,
filled,
который сталкивается с каким-то давлением в своей
faith,
жизни сейчас или будет в будущем, Господь, Я молюсь, чтобы он был
better.
Наполнен.
And through this,
каждый человек,
our faith
каждая семья были наполнены
And all we need in this life is to keep believing and trusting you because you are with us in every season of life. In the name of Jesus Christ,
amen. Продолжать доверять тебе, потому что ты с нами в каждом периоде жизни. Во имя Иисуса Христа. Аминь. В конце собрания я хотел бы предложить каждому молиться.
I would like to offer everyone to pray a simple prayer to reconcile with Christ.
Веришь ли ты
Do you believe in Him?
Доверял
Have you ever trusted Him your whole life? Have you ever asked Him to enter your life as Lord and Savior? This is a special moment for every person. Maybe a lot of people in the world believe that God exists, but never let Jesus Christ to become their Lord and Savior. The Bible says that this is the only way how we can come to God the Father in heaven. We cannot live good enough life to be holy and comply to God's standards that He outlined in His Word. And He gave us these standards to show every person that we cannot come to God without Jesus Christ, Savior. We need Jesus, all of us. He transforms our life. He changes our life. If you trust Him and open your heart to Him, and let's pray together, if you would love to pray this prayer, just close your eyes right now and repeat after me. Make this simple words your prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I come to you and I confess I am a sinner, and I need a Savior. I believe that God's Son, Jesus Christ, came to the cross and died for my sin. I also believe that He was risen on the third day to give me a new life. I receive forgiveness of all my sins. I receive the gift of salvation and also the gift of the Holy Spirit. And I believe that my life will never be the same again. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I congratulate you if you prayed this prayer. This is an important step in the relationship with God, and I believe that your life will be transformed and changed every day. I want to encourage you, wherever you are, be a part of the local church. If you're from Moscow, welcome to Hillsong Church services when we're going to have them. You can be a part of online services now. If you're from the different city, be a part of the local church there. Church is the gathering of believers, just regular people who believe in God, who help each other to build their life on God's foundation. We also congratulate you as a church, and we'll be happy to send you a small gift from our church, the Bible. If you pray this prayer, I want to ask you to leave your contact information on the page of the service on our website. And we'll be happy to congratulate you, to call you, to pray for you, and give you the small gift, the Bible. And also to the entire church, it's a great time right now. I'm happy that it is summer. This season of pandemic is starting to go away and life becomes regular again. But in any season of life, we need faith. How is your faith today? I believe that today, after this service, it is stronger, because God's Word strengthens our faith. So let's make this practical tomorrow, on Monday. Let's live it out, walk it out every day, every week, because God calls us to live by faith all the time. Amen? And I wish you the great Sunday. Spend it with family. Be blessed, and see you at 12 p.m. live in Instagram.